Now that we have discussed the WWC's four outcome measure standards, we will now discuss how the WWC checks for confounding factors. In brief, confounding factors are study components that make it difficult or impossible to distinguish between the effect of the intervention from the effect of that component. In this section of the training, we will provide examples of confounding factors, as well as examples of things that are not confounding factors. And finally, we will discuss how confounding factors affect a study's research rating. So what is a confounding factor? Confounding factors are components of a study that make it difficult or impossible to estimate the true effect of an intervention, because the effect of an intervention cannot be distinguished from the effect of that component. The WWC's definition of a confounding factor has three aspects. The first aspect is that confounding factors are observed study components. Examples of observed study components are characteristics of teachers, schools, or lesson materials. For instance, students' use of computers might be an observed study component. Conversely, typical unobserved components might include characteristics of study participants, like motivation. The second aspect is that confounding factors are components that align completely with one and only one of the study conditions. That is, the factor is present for all the units in one group and absent for all of the units in the other group. The third aspect is that confounding factors are components that are not actually part of the intervention the study is testing. For example, instructional materials provided only to intervention students as part of the intervention do not represent a confounding factor. However, after-school tutoring provided only to intervention students would represent a confounding factor if tutoring was not part of the intervention. Overall, the WWC is concerned about confounding factors because they prevent us from isolating the effect of an intervention. Confounding factors make it impossible to know whether the intervention alone is responsible for the observed effect or whether the confounding factor is responsible for some or all of the effect. Because of this challenge, findings from any study with a confounding factor will receive a research rating of does not meet WWC standards, and the review will stop at this stage. Importantly, however, if a study has multiple findings, and some of those findings are not affected by the confounding factor, then the WWC review will continue for those findings. However, in many cases, when a study has a confounding factor, it often affects all study findings. Let's talk about different types of confounding factors. One of the most common types occurs when a single study unit, such as a teacher, classroom, school, or district, aligns with one and only one study condition. The WWC often refers to this as an N equals one confounding factor. To avoid this type of confounding factor, a study must have at least two units in each condition. In group design studies with two conditions, this means the minimum analytic sample size is 4. Anything less than this would result in an N equals 1 confounding factor. For example, let's say a study randomly assigns two schools, one to each condition. This study would have an N equals 1 confounding factor because each condition only contains one unit. So, the study cannot distinguish the effect of the intervention from the effect of the one school where the intervention is implemented. But this type of N equals 1 confounding factor can also occur with larger samples, such as when a single instructor provides the intervention to all students and has no contact with the comparison group. This is a confounding factor because, again, it is impossible to determine whether the intervention alone is responsible for the observed intervention effect, or whether it is due to the instructor confound. Another type of confounding factor occurs when the characteristics of study units in the intervention group differ from those in the comparison group with no overlap. For this type of confounding factor, the characteristic must plausibly affect outcomes. One example is teacher qualifications. For example, if all teachers in the intervention group have a doctoral degree and no teachers in the comparison group have a doctoral degree, it is possible that something that the intervention teachers learned in their doctoral programs contributed to the observed impacts rather than the intervention itself. Another example of this type of confounding factor occurs when the comparison group consists of students who are in the same grade as the intervention group, but at a different point in time. For example, suppose the intervention group consists of students who were fourth graders in the 2019-2020 school year, and the comparison group consists of students who were fourth graders in the 2018-2019 school year. In this example, time is a confounding factor because the groups are observed in different school years. You may wonder, why does the WWC consider time a confounding factor? Well, in these scenarios, the intervention and comparison conditions align completely with different time periods. It is possible that something changed between the time periods that could cause differences between the groups, such as a change in school leadership, implementation of a new policy, or the onset of a global pandemic. In these scenarios, we cannot determine whether any observed impact is truly due to the intervention, due to something else that changed over time, or due to both. The WWC considers characteristics like teacher qualifications or time periods to be confounding factors when there is no overlap in the characteristic between the intervention and comparison group. So in the example where all the intervention teachers have a doctoral degree, if even one comparison group teacher also had a doctoral degree, the WWC would not consider the doctoral degree qualification to be a confounding factor since there is overlap across groups. It is important to note that some situations similar to those we just discussed may not always be confounding factors. Based on the WWC's definition, they only qualify as confounding factors when they are not part of the intervention. For example, an intervention might require teachers to have certain qualifications to implement the intervention. Or the study might be examining the effect of attending a specific type of school, such as a charter school. In these cases, the apparent confounding factor is actually part of the intervention the study is testing, and the WWC would not consider this a confounding factor. Let's take a look at some examples. Here's an example of a single unit that appears in both conditions. Let's say that Ms. Gonzalez teaches 6 math classes and implements a new math intervention in 3 of her 6 class periods. In her remaining class periods, the comparison classes, she teaches the regular curriculum. Although Ms. Gonzalez is the only teacher in the study, this is not a confounding factor because Ms. Gonzalez's teaching skills are present in both the intervention and the comparison group. Whether Ms. Gonzalez is a fantastic teacher or a struggling teacher, she is teaching class periods in both conditions, essentially controlling for any teacher effects. In this example, Ms. Gonzalez taught 3 class periods in each condition. What if there were only 2 classes in the experiment, and she taught only 1 class in each condition, 1 in the intervention group and 1 in the comparison group? In that case, there would be a confounding factor because it is the single class period in each condition that would represent an n equals 1 confounding factor, not Ms. Gonzalez. We would not be able to separate the effect of the intervention from the effect of being in that particular class period. Let us consider another example where an observed factor does not align completely with one of the study conditions. Let's consider a study in which the teachers in the intervention and comparison groups have different levels of experience. A study assigns 4 teachers and their classrooms to implement or not implement a new math curriculum. Both teachers in the intervention group have extensive teaching experience. One of the teachers in the comparison group is also experienced, but the other is a novice. Is experience or novice status a confounding factor in this example? Remember that the WWC requires that the study component align completely with one of the study conditions in order to be considered a confounding factor. In this example, at least one teacher with extensive experience appears in both conditions, so this characteristic is not a confounding factor. In other words, there is overlap in experience of teachers across the 2 groups. Although the novice teacher appears only in the comparison group, the other comparison group teacher is experienced. Because the comparison group is not comprised of only novice teachers, there is no confounding factor in this example. Another example of a non-confounding factor that may share some aspects of a confounding factor is volunteering for a study. Volunteers may have underlying characteristics that differ from the characteristics of study participants who do not volunteer. However, the WWC does not consider volunteering to be a confounding factor. Recruiting volunteers for a randomized controlled trial study is not a confounding factor if the study randomly assigns the volunteers to both conditions. Whatever motivates people to volunteer will be present in both conditions, so the volunteering does not align completely with one group. Using volunteers is not a confounding factor in quasi-experimental designs either. Let's think about why we might be concerned about a QED in which intervention group members volunteer to receive the intervention. We might worry that the volunteers are more motivated than comparison group members, which might affect outcomes. This is just an example of the general concern with QEDs, that the groups may differ on unobserved characteristics. Because this is always a concern in QEDs, the highest research rating a QED can receive is meets WWC standards with reservations. And the with reservations portion of this rating addresses the potential bias that arises from volunteering or other differences in observed characteristics. To sum up, then, although volunteering might seem to be an observed measure that could satisfy the definition of a confounding factor, the WWC treats volunteering as potentially influenced by an unobserved characteristic like motivation, and unobserved characteristics cannot be confounding factors. Knowledge check 4. The WWC is reviewing a study that examined the effects of a digital literacy intervention. Students were pulled from their homeroom for individual 30-minute tutoring sessions with the principal investigator once per week for 12 weeks. During the sessions, the students were provided with common tips on how to spot false or misleading news articles. A total of 123 students and one school participated in the study, with 61 assigned to receive the intervention and 62 assigned to receive the usual instruction. The baseline difference between the intervention and comparison group students on a reading pretest was 0.04 standard deviations. Which of the following would be a confounding factor in this study? A. Students in the intervention group volunteered to receive the intervention. B. The study sample was drawn from a single school. C. The principal investigator of the study acted as the tutor for the intervention. Or D. The intervention group was comprised of 5th and 6th graders, but the comparison group was only comprised of 5th graders. You may want to pause the video while you think about your answer. The correct answer is C. There is an N equals 1 confounding factor in this design because the intervention was implemented by a single person, the principal investigator, and that person had no interaction with the comparison group. The WWC does not consider volunteering to represent a confounding factor, and the WWC would not consider the single school a confounding factor, given that students from the school were present in both the intervention and comparison groups. Knowledge check 5. Half of the math teachers in a school implement a new supplemental math curriculum. 4 of the 5 teachers implementing the new curriculum have master's degrees. 1 of the 5 teachers in the comparison group has a master's degree. The other teachers in the comparison group only have bachelor's degrees. Is this a confounding factor based on the WWC's definition? Your answer options are A, yes, and B, no. You may want to pause the video while you think about your answer. The correct answer is B, no. There is no confounding factor in this study related to teacher education because the teacher's education does not completely align with only one group. In this example, there is at least one teacher in each group with a master's degree, and there is at least one teacher in each group without a master's degree. Knowledge check 6. Mr. Duncan's fourth period math class receives a new intervention and their fifth period math class receives the regular district curriculum. Is there a confounding factor here based on the WWC's definition? Your response options are A, yes, and B, no. You may want to pause the video while you think about your answer. The correct answer is A, yes, there is a confounding factor. There is a confounding factor in this design because there's a single class in each condition. This is an example of N equals one confounding factor. It is impossible to separate the effects of the intervention from any other effects of the particular class in the intervention group, such as classroom composition or peer effects that might influence outcomes. This concludes the fourth module in the WWC Group Design Standards training. Let's review what we discussed in this module. We reviewed the definition of an outcome measure and learned why the WWC assesses outcome measures used to demonstrate impacts in evaluations. We also reviewed how to describe and apply the four WWC outcome measure standards. We also reviewed the WWC's definition of a confounding factor and provided different examples of confounding factors as well as things that are not confounding factors. Remember that you can access all of these resources mentioned in this module on the WWC website, whatworks.ed.gov.